morning, everyone. If we would please rise for the start of our funeral mass for Ruth, and we will start with our opening song. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be always with you.
And with your spirit.
My friends, in the waters of baptism, Ruth died with Christ, and she rose with him to new life. We pray she will now share with him eternal glory. And let us pray. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant Ruth will also rise again. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
And friends, please be seated now for our scripture readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we looked to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." This is the word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is
Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths. For his name's sake, you spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
Reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. None of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God." So then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. Lord, alleluia, alleluia, give praise to his name.
Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to the risen Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, give praise to
We have been crucified with Christ. Now we shall live forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. On one occasion, Jesus spoke thus, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart. And you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Friends, as we have a chance to pause from our readings here to reflect upon Ruth and why we're here in this church that was obviously so important for her and for all of you, no doubt, on behalf of Deacon Whited, Deacon Scamp, our other deacons who weren't unfortunately able to be here due to other commitments, really the whole parish family, just our condolences to all of you. You know, I know it's been a little while since Mom passed away, but I hope that, you know, today and no doubt what has transpired since she passed in early March have been chances to let God's kind of grace, his consolation, just kind of envelop us, remind us of that bigger picture, right, that I always love to talk about in terms of where Ruth is right now and what's going on. No doubt, there's still, nonetheless, a lot of pain and sorrow, which is normal, right? That would be quite expected. But I suspect in some ways is a little tougher. I know she passed just a couple of days away from her 97th birthday. So, I mean, that would have been really awesome. But what I'll say is we'll just round up. And so she's at 97. But, you know, I I'm semi-joking, but, you know, whenever you get to sort of that age, you know, each year is kind of a special milestone, no doubt. So it would have been neat, but, of course, she had her birthday with God. So I think that's probably a better birthday than for us here on earth. I know that you shared with her dear friend, Eileen, obviously passing not too much, you know, apart. So them inseparable here on earth, why wouldn't it make sense? They're inseparable with God in heaven. So, you know, again, little things for us maybe to kind of reflect upon. But really what I'd like us to just start off with, even as we'll talk a little bit more about Mom and, of course, the resurrection. But, you know, I love that we did, in some ways, kind of hold off till we came to now the Easter season. So, you know, March 4th would have been smack dab in the midst of Lent. And so maybe we didn't reflect upon it at that point, but that Lent for all of you who, you know, were dear, that Ruth was so dear to all of you, it was a kind of a very unique Lent for all of you. You guys were really close to Jesus in his own sufferings as you saw Mom, you know, slowly but surely start declining, and then of course you pass, and then all that rest of Lent was a time of grieving. So, you know, maybe in many ways you guys were like those very early disciples who were, you know, with Jesus grieving and you know, recognizing, wow, this is the end here. And then they had to deal with, of course, the loss. But then, and then this is where I'm going. So then for them, 3 days later, it's like, wait a minute, whoa, what in the world's going on here? Jesus is alive. And now I know you might be saying, okay, that's where our kind of image or our kind of analogy falls a little bit for us, that, you know, we don't see Ruth anymore in our midst. So unlike those apostles who did have Jesus, at least for 40 more days at that point, right? But that's where our Lord is inviting us. We who have faith in him know that all of his disciples who have loved him, who have served him, are sharing in that resurrection already, even though if we on this side of the veil don't see physically. But then again, that's where St. Paul reminds us. Faith is not, oh, I see everything and that's why I believe, but I believe because of Jesus and his resurrection. And so he's inviting us to just deepen that faith in him. So then again, why I love that here we are in the Easter season, able to, kind of reflect upon that. So, you know, again, with that sort of a little longer introduction aside, but, you know, obviously to Ruth's children, to James and to Scott, to Jill and Rachel, although I believe Rachel's not here, and then to her children through marriage, April, Elaine, and Mike, and Pat, her grandchildren, her great-grandchildren, everyone else. We are, again, sorry for your loss, and our prayers have been with you throughout this month, a little more than a month, and we'll continue to, and I know through the prayers that we'll have at the cemetery how important. So, again, you know, I'm sure there are so much more that you all have already reflected upon, in that month, as I said. But I guess I didn't maybe know this at first, or if maybe I was aware of it, I forgot about it. But, you know, James, very much appreciated your taking time out of a busy schedule to come in and talk with me. So Mom grew up in Wisconsin, Northwest Wisconsin. So my mom's house is near Eau Claire. So when I saw that, I'm like, holy smokes, I knew there was some reason. I especially like Ruth. But at any point, you know, how great it was for 12 years now to be able to be her pastor. You know, I know in many ways COVID kind of put a number on that, and then with her being over at the nursing home, kind of a little fewer and far between interactions. But, how wonderful it is when we are able to gather together and celebrate the life of one who lived a great life, right? That's what it's all about. And, you know, I love the fact that, as it said in her obit, which, James, you reminded me, she wrote it. So, I mean, like, I'm glad she had a lot of good things to say about herself. But she reminded us that even into her 90s, she was giving out advice on a medical level, right? So, God bless her. At her heart, she was that nurse. And, I never obviously had her as, you know, a nurse or something like that, but I'd have to believe from what I know about her, when you have those really profound nurses who love their job, but more importantly, they love those individuals to whom they come into contact with and they minister to. And I'm using that word in the most appropriate sense. It is truly a labor of love. And a labor where, if you remember, Jesus reminded us that whatever you do for brother or sister, you're doing it for the Lord. So I'd love to imagine Ruth in all of her interactions, wherever it was. You know, I know she was many different places. It said Wisconsin, California, then here, of course, in Pekin, and then even in private practice. But, you know, taking such good care of everyone that came across her path. I mean, that's really what it's all about. In fact, what shouldn't be lost on us is that, you know, kind of the whole idea of why Jesus came into this world, why he ultimately died on the cross, and then, of course, in this Easter season, rose from the dead, was to bring healing and health to each one of us. I mean, that's what it boils down to. In fact, one of the great icons are just kind of those pictures from of old that remind us of aspects of our Lord's life. But one of the main ones from early on was how Jesus was the divine physician, that he came to bring us healing. So I love it, especially when we can ponder on one who literally followed after Jesus in that idea of bringing health to others. Of course, how can I forget that Ruth had such a profound love for this parish, most especially in the school. I know she, you know, you mom and dad, you know, make sure you guys were at the school, but she would spend so many afternoons volunteering there in the kitchen, right? Making sure that all the little ones were being taken care of, fed. I wonder if in so many different ways she kind of like, oh, they need a little bit more than what we're supposed to be given out, and out of love, right, we're taking care of them. But, you know, as we ponder all of those things, I want us to not forget that, you know, as opposed to just kind of praising the individual, we do that by also inserting them into the mystery of what we celebrate here, Mass. So at every Mass, our minds and our hearts are brought back to Jesus and his sacrifice for each one of us. That it was that sacrifice made out of love that brings us the gift to have eternal life in and through the Son. All right, and so that's where our readings come into play, reminding us of not just a life well lived by Ruth on this earth, but what a life well lived by her is now meriting, namely life with God. So I love that first reading, right? That beautiful image of that with our own eyes, we're going to see the glory of God brought up to his kingdom, and how at that point there's no more suffering. You know, again, I know you shared that, you know, towards the end there, not able to see as much, you know, your mom. And then, of course, after she broke her leg and you know, was able not able to you know, do the things. And you saw her declining, right? And yet through that decline, actually, she was being prepared for fullness of life. So again, with her own eyes, she is seeing our Lord. But I love that St. Paul's reading really kind of reminded us of what life is all about. Remember that beautiful phrase he says, no one lives for themselves, no one dies for themselves. When we live for others, and that's what Ruth did, as I was just explaining, the sacrifices she made, the going out of her way to help, right? No one lives for oneself. She lived for others. And because of that, she's sharing in that life of Jesus, who he came to this earth to die for each one of us. Beautiful kind of juxtaposition that's going on there. So then, lastly, to kind of maybe wrap this all up and put a nice tidy bow on it, I love today's gospel, right? Where Jesus is reminding how all of us of how he invites his disciples, who in each of our lives, each one of us in some way, have a share in his cross. And he says, come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and he will take that burden on himself. So I love that that can be seen in a couple of different ways for us here. So first, for all of you who are no doubt mourning and still filled with sadness with Ruth's passing, come to Jesus. Give him that sorrow and that sadness. And he'll put his arm around you and remind you she's alive with him. But then for her, again, think about all the labor she did throughout her, we're rounding up again, 97 years of life. And the good Lord is saying, come now to your rest. You labored so well on this earth. You took such great care of so many people. You loved everybody with an infinite love. So now come, take your rest. That allows us to imagine the reunions that are going on right now with her and with so many people up there. And then it lastly reminds us that if we follow her example, what a great reunion there is. there will be for each one of us. So again, friends, my condolences to all of you. Please know of our continued prayers. But, you know, even as you have tears, you know, shed for Ruth, let those be tears of joy that her life, which was so well lived, is now being continued forever with God. And as long as we keep that faith that she had, keep that example of love that she had, we will see her again. And we'll see God and we'll be with him forever then in his kingdom of heaven.
Friends, please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, we know that Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and that he sits at the right hand of his Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we now join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Ruth received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, our sister Ruth was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy. Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy, those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy, the family and friends of Ruth seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Ruth. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your kingdom. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Friends, please be seated at this time.
Amen.
Friends, please stand and pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Ruth may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Please kneel or be seated at this time. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Louis, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Ruth, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Friends, please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And friends, the peace of the Lord be with you always. Please kneel or be seated at this time. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Now, friends, a little announcement. So in a few moments, we'll have time for communion. There will be two stations for communion, one on either side of the remains of Ruth, if we'd like to come down that center aisle. Now, for those who perhaps are not Catholic or who are unable to receive communion for any other reason, if you'd still like to come forward for a blessing, I would certainly invite you, but I would ask that you would cross your arms like this to signal that you would like a blessing.
Asia plena, Maria gratia plena, Ave. Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus, et benedictus fructus ventris, ventris tui, Jesus. Ave Maria.
Friends, please stand and let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Ruth, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, friends, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. For one day we shall joyfully greet Ruth again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Ruth in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Ruth in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Ruth forever. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now, friends, in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
Yeah.
She disappeared. It's like the only thing I can think of.
Oh, yeah, we can do this. All right. I'll give you the candle, and I'll let go. Face going.
Oh, yeah. You're fine. And I just twist it one way or the other, and finally it's there. It's looking good. Okie doke.